Good morning to all. In this session, we discuss one concept, many questions. What's the concept here? Mechanism of urine formation. This is the important topic to give more chances to ask questions from this concept in your examinations. How the questions will be asked from this session like this. See, some practice questions I gave here. Pranita is suffering from diabetes insipidus and what are its symptoms? Diabetes insipidus is a deficiency of hormonal disease which was caused by lack of vasopressin hormone. Because vasopressin hormone, the presence of vasopressin hormone, concentration of urine takes place in the area of collecting tubes. If vasopressin hormone is not there, what will happen? The urine gets diluted urine. So this hormone maintains osmotic concentration of the body fluids. Can simply say deficiency of vasopressin is the reason for diabetes insipidus. So the reason, the symptoms, what are the symptoms here? Excessive repeated diluted urination is called diabetes insipidus. So next question. Draw the mechanism of urine formation in the form of flow chart. So mechanism of urine formation, it has a four steps. First step is glomerulus filtration and the second step is tubular reabsorption and the third step is tubular secretion and the fourth step is formation of hypertonic urine. So these four steps involved in the formation of urine. So what is that surprises you in the urinary system? Why? So the urinary system, that means here we can give, not only we can write the answer from, not only from nephron, we can write the urinary system means the complete kidneys and the urinary bladder, ureter, we can write all these things in this part. For example, I gave here some of the points. So the size of the kidney is half size of the urinary bladder and each kidney contains millions of, that means nearly 1.3 to 1.8 millions of the urinary tubules, that is nephrons. So nephrons are the filtrating units in the kidney. It is estimated that is an average person's lifetime approximately kidneys filter 7 to 8 billion gallons of urine. The lifetime of kidney, the human being lifetime, the kidneys filters 7 to 8 billion gallons of the urine. So these are the answers for these three questions. In the next slide, these are the questions. Why nephrons are called structural and functional units of the kidney? Nephrons are present in each kidney. Millions of nephrons are present in each kidney. Nearly 1.3 to 1.8 nephrons are present in each kidney. So these nephrons are the filtrating units in kidney. So the main function of kidney is filtrate the blood. So it was going in the nephrons only. So next, write the difference between PCT and DCT. So PCT is the full form of, what is PCT? Proximal convoluted tubule. And DCT for distal convoluted tubule. So PCT is responsible for the reabsorption of substances like water, glucose, etc. And DCT, it is responsible for the reabsorption like sodium, potassium, chloride, etc. So these ions will be reabsorbed in DCT and in PCT reabsorption, tubular reabsorption takes place in PCT and tubular secretion is going in DCT. So the PCT helps to regulate the concentration of the water and organic solutes. and DCT, this maintains the proper concentration of pH of urine. Next, already explained this, I explained this question. And what happens if tubular reabsorption does not occur? If tubular reabsorption does not happen, if reabsorption of water does not take place in PCT, all useful substances, nutrients, water, along with the waste will be excreted. So next question is a draw a neat label diagram of mechanism of urine formation. So you have to draw the diagram and mechanism of this question may be given for your examination, maybe 4 marks or 8 marks. So because draw a label diagram and mechanism of urine formation, that means you have to write the 4 steps involved. What are the glomerular filtration, tubular secretion, and tubular reabsorption and tubular secretion and formation of hypertonic urine. So all these steps, you put a side headings and write the explanation of these steps. Next, explain glomerular filtration. Explain glomerular filtration. So blood, whenever the blood flows from renal artery to glomerulus through the afferent arteriole. So afferent arteriole brings, whenever the afferent arteriole enters into the Bowman's capsule. So Bowman's cap, it will be divided into form a small brass, fine blood capillaries, and it comes out from the, in the form of efferent arteriole. So efferent arteriole has a narrower outlet compared to the afferent arteriole. So the narrower outlet exerts the pressure inside the glomerulus. This pressure will helps to filtrate the waste materials or nutrients materials from the glomerulus into Bowman's capsule. So the first filtration will be called as a primary urine. So when move to next slide. So explain the role of vasopressin in the form of formation of urine. So concentration of urine takes place in the area collecting tubes in the presence of hormone called vasopressin. So this hormone is secreted only when concentrated urine is to be passed out. If vasopressin hormone is not there, then what will happen? The urine becomes diluted. So the water will be removed from, lots of water will be we lost from our body. So what happens if vasopressin hormone is decreased? If vasopressin hormone is decreased in our body, so the person will produce dilute urine. For example, the person get may disease called diabetes insipidus. So the symptoms of the diabetes insipidus is excessive and repeated and dilute urination is called diabetes insipidus. For example, the normal person can pass the urine per day is 1.1 liter to 1.5 liter, nearly 2 liters. But if the person lost vasopressin hormone, the person may excrete nearly 25 liters of urine. So this is the, if person lost 25 liters of water, then what will happen? The person body gets dehydrated. If you drink more water, will you pass more urine? Yes, if you drink more water, more consumption of water will leads to more urine output. If you consume more water, the person excrete more urine also. Next slide. Why more urine is produced during winter? In winter, all the sweat pores will be blocked. That means the climate is cold, sweat is produced in very less quantity. So waste are not eliminated in the form of sweat.
So, the waste from the blood, more urine is produced in winter. So, what are the substances reabsorbed in peritubular network from proximal convoluted tubule? Here, reabsorption takes place in the second step. What are the amino acids? Glucose, vitamin C, potassium, calcium, sodium, chlorides, and 75% of water will be reabsorbed from PCT into peritubular network. So what are the substances that secrete into DCT? Secretes into DCT from where? From peritubular network into DCT. What are the substances secrete here? Excess some waste materials like urea, uric acid, creatinine, salt ions like potassium, sodium, and H+ ions. So this maintains the proper concentration of pH of urine. Okay, if you have any doubt in this session, you will comment me in comment session. Then I will explain. If you want any session or if you want any concept, you want that one, you will comment me in comment session. I will discuss in this session, next session. Okay, thank you for watching this video. Please share my videos and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Okay, thank you.